with the 12 tribes and it's like I heard that most of us is really the tribe of Judah here and not all these different people. Like
no.
Yeah, the Guatemalans.
Okay. Alright. So here's a question that we never really ask ourselves. Because you heard that, right?
Yeah.
Which one of you were ever taught Spanish history? Bring it up. Which one of you were ever taught Native American history?
Slightly,
right?
Yeah, slightly.
Were you taught that the burial grounds in Idaho, Omaha, in those areas, they were found tablets with Hebrew writing on it?
Yeah, and giants and some giants.
So wait a minute. Did you know that the pyramids in Peru and Guatemala are the same exact dynamics of the pyramids in Egypt?
Yeah.
How is that? You knew that.
I grew up in Brazil and I went to Muslim school.
So how is it that the Native Indians built the pyramids the exact same way as they were built in Egypt?
They stole it.
At what point? Oh, the white people. Because the Native Indians, their forefathers, were also in Egypt.
That's right.
They are the children of Israel.
That's right.
Let's just sum it up real quick for you.
All right.
Oh, you got a question too? Come back. Ready? All right.
When y'all gonna be back out here again?
Every Sabbath day. You got a flyer? Make sure she got a flyer. Oh. Get to the spirit of truth. Gotta go back to spirit of truth.
You still haven't told me about the church. What was supposed to do when you said no church?
Oh, man. Woo! It's a workout today. Hey, all right.
What y'all reward y'all part of y'all good work.
All praise to the Most High. Let me get John 6. John 6 and 63.
You gotta watch that movie. The Bible time. You gotta see that.
Go ahead. John 6 and 6. Because we're supposed to worship God in spirit and in truth, right?
Amen.
Let's see how we're supposed to worship God.
This is the book of John, chapter 6, verse 63.
Uh-huh.
It is the spirit that quickeneth.
So it's the spirit that changes you. Quickeneth means change. It's the spirit that changes you. Read.
The flesh profited nothing.
Well, your flesh don't profit anything because your flesh is sin, right? Well, let's see.
The words that I speak unto you.
So these words here,
they are spirit.
What?
They are spirit.
We worship God in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
We should worship God according to these words. Right? You agree?
Yeah, I agree.
Now let's go to Psalms 119 and 142. Let's see what the truth is. It says worship God in spirit and in truth. So we see we have to worship God according to thus saith the Lord out of this Bible, right? Let's see what the truth is. Let's see what the Bible says. Because guess what? Anything that's not in here is a lie.
That's right.
Anything that's not in here is a lie. So I understand you chiming in, but if it's not coming out of here, it's a lie, brother. Read. 119 verse 142.
Read up.
Come on,
brother. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 142.
Uh-huh.
Thy righteousness. It's an everlasting righteousness.
So God's righteousness is everlasting. There's no end to it. Read.
And thy law.
And is what?
And thy law.
And is what?
And thy law. Is the truth.
Wait a minute. So we worship God in spirit and in truth. We worship him according to the Bible and his law.
That's right.
You understand?
That's how we worship God. We don't know that though. We've never been taught that. That's why we're out here. Isaiah 58 and 1.
Bring it up. I know somebody's got a question.
Bible.
You got a question?
The Bible, right?
Huh?
Talking about the Bible. We establish the church, establish the floor, something like that. On top of the rock.
The church, this house shall be built on the rock?
Yeah.
Talking about Christ. The foundation of the earth. The foundation of everything we teach is in Christ. Everything we teach is in the spirit of Christ.
So it's not actually a church?
We have a school, yes. We have a school that you can come and learn, yes. We have a school. Hold that.
I missed my bus because I was listening.
And guess what? That's the best thing you've gotten today, sister.
Let me ask you.
Out of seven and four.
That verse that you was telling me about the thin blonde hair.
Leviticus 13 and 30.
Leviticus, because my nephew is well versed in the Bible. Leviticus 13 and 30. One thing.
Yes.
Hold on. Go back to that one.
What's that?
About the church?
You know, Barney's right.
No, I need to hear about that.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 48. Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands,
Is your church a temple made by hands?
Made by man.
Yeah.
You know what?
Made by hands.
Yes.
Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet.
So now, we like to think God, this is God's house. Uh-huh. Correct? Look, don't be confused, sister. You've never been taught that. But guess what? The prophets are back in the earth to teach you correctly.
Yes. Yes. Right.
Hold on. Hold back. Right. What is that? God. Jeremiah 3 and 15. Look. Yeah. Jeremiah 3 and 15. The Bible says God is not dwelling in that temple. We just read it. Did we not just read it?
Yeah.
Okay. Jeremiah 3 and 15. Acts 7 and 48. The book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 48. Acts chapter 7 verse 48. Read that.
This Jeremiah. Is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, verse 15. I will give you pastors.
Say that again.
I will give you pastors.
So God told Jeremiah, I'm going to send pastors
according to my heart.
According to God's heart, according to God's mind. So they're going to be pastors in the earth who are actually teaching according to God's word. That's who you see before you this day.
That's right.
All right? Go ahead.
Which shall feed you.
What are they going to do?
Which shall feed you.
Not a soup kitchen line, is it? Go ahead.
Which shall feed you with knowledge.
What are they going to feed you with?
With knowledge and understanding.
Have you been getting understanding this day?
Spiritual knowledge and understanding.
By the word of God.
But you've been getting understanding this day. It said these pastors after the Lord's mind are going to teach you knowledge and understanding.
Right.
Have you been getting understanding this day?
Yes, I have.
You have. Yeah. Malachi 2 and 7.
Get up!
Malachi 2 and 7. Switch out.
Question though. Beeping all these stuff.
Hold on. Let's see what the pastors according to God's mind are going to do. Read.
The book of Malachi, chapter 2, verse 7.
Come on.
For the priest's lips.
So those same priests that God says, according to his mind, are going to teach you knowledge and understanding. But so these same priests, what are they going to teach?
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
Uh-huh. That's the knowledge it mentioned, right? Go ahead.
And they should seek the law.
What are they going to seek at the priest?
They should seek the law.
The law?
At his mouth.
So what are the priests supposed to be teaching you that are of God's mind?
Knowledge.
Knowledge, which is what? What is the knowledge?
Understanding.
Read what the knowledge that the priest supposed to teach you.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
So this is the knowledge that it said the priest after God's mind is going to teach you. Here's what the knowledge is.
And they should seek the law at his mouth.
So we brought out the beard. We brought out the hair, we brought out the women in pants, we brought out the Sabbath day, things of that nature. The priests are going to teach you these things, Isaiah 58 and 1. That's what the priests of God are going to teach you. You understand that? Because you said y'all go to church and your pastors don't tell you that thing. So which one is of God? The one that doesn't teach you according to knowledge and understanding, or the ones that do?
The ones that do
is what you get from the state,
or
the priest is the Most High.
Isaiah chapter
58
verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Cry aloud!
Uh-huh, that's why we speak so loud, because the Bible commands us to cry aloud so that brothers and sisters by the bus stop over there can hear us. Read.
Cry aloud.
Uh-huh.
Spare not.
Don't spare anyone's feelings. It doesn't matter if he was a pastor or not. We're going to go into the word of God and give him what the Bible says.
That's right.
We're going to spare nobody's feelings.
Too
sisters.
Much empathy.
Yeah, we don't have no empathy. We're going to give you as thus saith the Lord. That's what men of the Lord do. Read.
Lift up thy voice. Like a trumpet.
That's why we speak loud. Come on.
And show my people.
What does God want us to do?
Show my people their transgressions.
Show our people their sins.
And the house of Jacob their sin.
That's why we're out here. To show you the sins you're in that you can repent and come back to God. Y'all understand that?
Okay. I understand. I got a question.
I'm going to let the soldier come up and answer your question. All right.
The captain's bringing out what we're supposed to do and repent. You know how to repent, sister. You know how to repent. How you repent?
You stop doing everything that's from sin.
How do you repent?
Stop doing everything that's in sin.
Everything we talk
about.
That's the sorrowful.
Well, what you've been taught, just like the captains and the deacons have been brought out, everything you've been taught has been a lie. So we're here to tell you the truth on how to repent.
A lot of us is on the poor poverty level. Okay? A lot of us, as I said, cannot afford fish and cannot afford chicken. Say in my fridge right now, all I got is just beef and chicken, but yesterday, beef and pork. But yesterday I just learned that it's not right for you to eat any filthy animal. But all I got in my fridge now is filthy animals. What am I supposed to do then?
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 119, verse 60. I made haste.
What does it say? What does haste mean, sister? Okay, praise, keep it going.
And delayed not to keep thy commandments.
Do me a favor, start at 59. Start at 59.
Verse 59. I thought on my ways.
Because he thought on his ways. You've been out here learning all this nice today, so now you're thinking on your ways. Continue to read.
And turn my feet unto thy testimonies.
So that means you turn into this Bible. Read.
I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments.
So it says delay not to keep the commandments. So what you have to do, sister? Sister, you gotta throw the pork away. If you truly love God,
what are you gonna eat?
That's when you go into this. You can't go to the store and start over with whatever.
So you can't eat chicken and beef.
Yeah, you can eat chicken and beef. Pork, I don't think it's not clean. But we're going. Let's go back to repentance. Yeah, you can eat beef. You got beef. You say you got beef. You just have to ration it out, sister. Go ahead. Let's go back. Now we're going to show you how to repent. Because your question was how do we repent. We're going to show you how to repent.
1 Kings chapter 8, verse 46. If they sin against thee.
Now, Most High said, God, if they sin against me, we all established we've been in sin. We guys have been in sin, right? We're in sin.
For there is no man that sinneth not.
No man. Continue to read.
And thou be angry with them.
Mm-hmm.
And deliver them to the enemy.
Now, how do we get over again? We established this earlier. How do we get on this side of the world?
Taking them to slavery.
Into slavery. That was God's punishment. Go ahead.
So that they carry them away captives.
Mm-hmm.
Unto the land of the enemy.
Now you're in that land right now. That's America.
Far or near.
Far or near.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
Sister, what does bethink mean?
Huh?
What does bethink mean? The word bethink.
I don't know.
Means to remember.
Okay.
Means to remember.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
So the Most High is saying, if you think about it, remember who you are. So we're bringing out to say. Go ahead.
In the land, whether they were carried captives.
Here in America, read.
And repent.
And repent. Read.
And make supplication.
Yes, to make supplication. What does supplication mean?
Supplication.
Please express it with your mouth. You got to express it more high.
Speak it out.
It's the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 10. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness.
Now we already established what the heart is, right? We know that's the mind. Read.
There you go.
And with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
That's supplication. With your mouth, you have to express it. Most God, I've been in sin. I've been wearing pants, but I'm going to change. Lord, forgive me for that. That's supplication. With your mouth. Go back to 1 Kings.
And make supplication unto thee in the land of them that carried them captives.
All right.
Saying, we have sinned.
We have sinned.
And have done perversely. We have committed wickedness. And so return unto thee.
Return to the Lord. The Lord will be bringing out these laws today. You can go back, return from all your wicked ways, King.
With all their heart.
With your mind, agree.
And with all their soul.
Huh?
In the land of their enemies.
So that's where you make your repentance here. You confess your sins to the Most High God, ask for forgiveness, and don't do it anymore. And we're going to bring out, there's a couple other brothers still in, and a law that we're not keeping right now. Okay, you got the flyers, you got the school address on the back of the number. Give us a call, sister. Learn the history, learn more.
Yes.
Oh, you are. Next time we see you, we'll be seeing you in the what?
Okay.
In the skirt. Dress. Okay. All praise. 15 mamas, 15 30.
Yes, of course, brother.
Yeah, brother. Yes. Look,
see, I got a question. It's like a three-part question for real. It has everything to do with the seed of the people who basically have stolen us, seen here, I guess the Edomite nations, the white races, whatever. When I'm looking at the chart, it's like a lot of these people on here, kind of, you know, they are basically from the spawn of the progenitors of the people who enslaved people. So it's just like if they are the sons and daughters of the people who actually stole Judah or stole Levi and everything, how can their descendants be basically, you know, a part of, you know, how can the children of the white man, period, you know, how can they be on the chart? Like, you know, how can they be, you know, holy or anything? Well,
let's set the Bible to you, because the scripture also says spirit, man. That's what we're gonna get for you.
It's the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 16. The spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
So your spirit is going to bear witness about it. If your spirit is not bearing witness about it, you don't want to hear it. You'll probably leave. It's like, I don't want to hear this. What are they talking about?
Yeah,
the wicked flee when they're on pursuit. Leave. Oh, now. But now. But that's how we, you know, we can't do the facial thing like somebody looks like this, looks like that. Hosea 7:8. That's why we can't go by a look. It's not about looks. It's not about skin color, about not skin tone. It's about the spirit. That's only.
So anybody can claim this thing. So what a white man can say is he's...
Well, yeah, they got identified by the curse.
My thing is, when you see all this interracial dating and all that type of stuff, it's 124 million white men. It's 39 million black Hebrews, whatever you want to call it, you know, everything. When these guys got more money and can come over here and still hip-hop, still get close to what our culture is, they can get close to the women. I mean, that's all a genocidal thing. So my thing is, like, regardless of white Cubans or whoever, I'm thinking, like, I know you're saying the spirit, but it's just like, what if they were to stand up here and act like they're y'all? Or act like they're us.
Well, do you ever read Genesis 49?
I know points in it. Nah.
Do you ever read Deuteronomy 33?
Nah, because I'm not really asking questions. That's all.
According to Genesis 49, according to Deuteronomy 33, these are the Israelites. As a matter of fact, when you look at starting right here, the so-called, starting here, all the way down. Yeah. When you look at the so-called Spanish, they got more proof in the Bible they're Israelite than us.
That's right.
There is way more proof they're Israelite than us. So I always baffle when somebody's talking about they're not Israelite. There is more proof in the Bible they are the Israelite than the so-called Negroes.
Right.
Yeah, they got more proof.
Well, if it's all spirit, then how come white men aren't up here stealing the faith?
Brother. Again, according to Genesis chapter 49, the so-called white man is not our people. And by the way, that's have nothing to do with skin color. I know a lot of us thinking, oh, this is after skin color. That have nothing to do with skin color. This is about your nationality. Your nationality. That's what it's about. This is about skin color. Genesis 49. Start at verse 1.
Genesis chapter 49, verse 1. And Jacob called unto his son.
Jacob's name was changed to Israel. Jacob have 12 sons. Jacob was about to die. Jacob called his 12 sons, which is these people right here. Jacob called his 12 sons. Read what Jacob's going to say about the 12 sons.
And said.
This is what Jacob said.
Gather yourselves together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days.
Jacob said. Come, gather yourself, come to me. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen to you in the last days. This is the last days.
That's right.
According to the prophecy, America is the last kingdom on the planet Earth before Christ comes back. This is the last days. Read what Jacob said to them.
Gather yourselves together that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last days.
Which shall befall you. What's going to happen to you in the last days? What Jacob is about to say? Jacob is about to tell you where each tribe is going to end up. Remember, the prophecy is, yes, the Israelites are going to scatter in the four corners of the earth. That is why Christ said, go teach the gospel all over the world. Why? Because Christ knows the prophecy, no matter where you go on the earth, you're going to find an Israelite. However, what Jacob is about to say is, Jacob is going to tell you where majority of them, for example, Judah. Jacob is going to tell you, Judah, you're going to find majority of Judah in this part of the earth. Benjamin. Jacob is going to tell you the tribe of Benjamin, which is so-called the Jamaican, the West Indies, the islands. Jacob is going to explain to you where they're going to be, majority of them is going to be. Is that mean if you go in any part of the earth, you're not going to find this so-called one of the so-called Jamaican? That's not what that means. But he's going to say where majority of them is going to be. Where the bulk of them is going to be. Levi, when you look at the so-called Haitian, the so-called Dominican, they're in the same island. But guess what? One of them speaks Creole, one of them speaks Spanish. How the hell that can be?
French count?
The Bible explained that to you, why that happened. You just got to know what it is. You just got to have a teacher to teach it to you. But this thing about, oh, how come the Northern Kingdom, the so-called Spanish, this have nothing to do about skin color. Stop, get that to you, get that off your mind.
But it's not about skin color.
No,
well,
it's not about skin color. Okay. I'm going to give you an example. When you look at Bob Marley,
his dad is white.
His dad is so-called white man.
Yeah.
Is he one of us? No, he's not.
Yeah, he's not.
But when you look at him, he looks just like us.
Yeah.
Lenny Kravitz, he looks just like us.
That's Jewish, right?
But that's not our people. Yeah, that's not, this is about skin color. It's about your nationality.
Yeah.
That's what this is about.
To the
father. So, yes, the so-called Hispanic, they are our people. And the Bible told you they are our people.
Yeah. Come on. I mean, that kind of that conflicts again. Because the only reason why they're Hispanic is because the Spaniards came over there and raped their women.
Psalms 15, 16.
That's the only reason why they're there.
Oh, yes, sir.
This book is called, I don't like the mixing of the nations. I don't get it. Like, you know what I mean? Like women bowing down to the same people that conquered their... Like, look around now. Like, listen, you know, you get girls who really want.
This is called Origins of the American Indians. This was published in 1967. What were we doing in 1967?
What were we doing?
Yeah.
Not even, you know.
We were still getting holes down, right?
Getting attacked by dogs black and stuff, people. Right?
I'm going to read something to you.
A historian wrote this. He says, the Mexicans are originally of the 10 tribes captured by Salomon Esar and of the family of Issachar, whom the Indians recognize as their special ancestor.
Yes,
Aztecs, right.
The Aztecs, right.
The Aztecs.
So as you see, Issachar right down there is the so-called Mexican Aztecs. Okay.
They don't include all of them though.
Just like we just mentioned, not all of us who are here in this land that look just like us are. They're not all Israel.
And came over here on planes after slavery.
Exactly.
So the original Mexicans are the shorter Aztecs, and the taller ones were like Enrique Iglesias. Those are the Spaniards.
Well, that's why we brought out Romans chapter 8. It's about the spirit. We can't tell. We can't tell. Most High knows who his elect are. So guess what? So now, you can turn around and tell us who to teach.
Yeah, that's what I want.
So we should stop teaching everybody and just teach who you say to teach.
Yeah.
Nah, that's not how Most High God said it.
So teach everybody.
Matthew 24:14.
Bring it out.
Remember, it's not about our understanding, it's about what God said.
Yeah. Because I'm just going over biology and population and those.
But guess what? Remember, science opposes the Bible.
That's right.
Always remember that. What's that in 1 Timothy 5:20?
6:20.
Let's get that first. I'm sorry. My bad. Just real quick. I'm going to bring two quick scriptures. Because guess what, bro? It's not according to how we feel. A lot of times, it's about how we feel. We try to squeeze the Bible into how we feel. No, we have to conform to what the Bible says.
That's right.
I agree.
It's not the other way around. Right. God is not going to change his word for us.
Right.
We have to change according to his word. Read.
1 Timothy 6:20.
Come on.
O Timothy, keep that which is committed to thy trust.
So what is committed to Timothy's trust? This Bible. Go ahead.
Avoiding profane and vain babbling.
Avoid that. So sometimes when people come up here scoffing, Bible says avoid that. Avoid. Don't entertain those who come against you. I say, you niggas is this and that. We're never going to get involved in that. We don't care what they say because we're out here to teach God's people. Go ahead.
And oppositions of science.
See that? It says avoid oppositions of science. When you get into genealogies, to biologies, things of that nature, the Bible says it's an opposition. It opposes the Bible because God says the spirit bear witness. That's what God says. So we can't say, his genetic makeup bears witness. The Bible says science opposes the Bible.
And a Negro third generation.
Say again?
And a Negro third generation black.
Now, here's the thing. Where was the Negro made?
Right.
Where was it made? From Jerusalem?
The Negro was made in America.
That's right.
The Negro was made in America. And same thing with our intelligence. It was made in America.
I thought the Romans called us Negroes from around that time.
Well, God called us niggers in the book of Ecclesiasticus and in the book of Acts when we're
word
in
Negro
Rome.
Really ain't even a bad word. Everybody just takes it like
read.
Matthew chapter 24:14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world.
No, only in certain areas.
In all the world.
What does it mean when it says it shall be preached in all the world? Why?
Why? Tell me why. Why should the gospel be preached in all the world?
So they can get the spirit and get the awakening everywhere.
Now, the everybody must know God's word.
Is it everybody?
Everybody.
Set out there. Give me Deuteronomy 28:64.
In all the world for a witness unto all nations.
Uh-huh.
And then
shall the end come.
So when this gospel is preached in all nations,
right,
then shall the end come. Let's see why it says all nations.
When everybody wake up.
Nah. Deuteronomy 28:64.
Bring it up. Deuteronomy 28:64.
Because remember, who was this Bible given to?
It's given to the slaves, the people being oppressed.
Now, prior to that, who did God give the Bible to?
Oh, the Hebrews.
To the Israelites.
Yeah.
So wait,
the Bible is to the Israelites, about the Israelites, for the Israelites.
That's right.
So how do we equate everybody else in there?
Right.
When the Bible says it shall be preached unto a witness unto all nations, let's see why. Read.
And the Lord shall scatter thee.
Call it.
Deuteronomy 28:64.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord shall scatter thee.
What?
Shall scatter thee,
uh-huh,
among all people.
Wait a minute.
We went into slavery with all people.
So we're in among all people.
Second, you will find a remnant of Israel everywhere on the planet. That is why we must teach this gospel everywhere on the planet.
Yeah.
It's not about, there's no Israelites in Portugal. That's not what God says.
Because Portugal was one of the first places that instituted the slave trade.
Right.
Right.
So yes, there's Israelites in Portugal. So we have to stop trying to conform the Bible to us and conform to the Bible.
Right? That's right. Now, you're asking all these questions, but we're going to get the conclusion. Go back to Deuteronomy 10 and 12.
Because I'm thinking, you know, these names of these places, these geological areas, was just named. So that's why I kind of be looking at biology, because it's all about the seeds of the fathers. Wherever the father goes, he creates what he is. You know what I mean?
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
Now, what we've been bringing out all day is your nationality, trying to teach your people. Yes, sir.
Well, what that got to do with your salvation?
Like I said, I'm already with y'all. I'm really just trying to get to the bottom of the...
No, you're not with us.
The 12 tribes.
If you was with us, you would have kept the law. You ain't keeping no law, so you're not with us. You're not. I can tell you're not keeping the law.
Yeah.
How do I know? Now you got to ask yourself a question. How do I know you're not keeping the law? How do I know you're not keeping the law?
Go ahead.
Give me the scripture. You know what I want. You're not with us. You ain't keeping no law. You're not with us.
Yeah, I ain't yet. I got
because
too much left.
The question is, all these questions you ask, they have nothing to do with your salvation. They have all this thing you think you know. If Christ comes today, he's gonna kill you.
Right. Yeah.
And I'm gonna show it to you.
Well, I know I'm not keeping the law.
Yeah.
But you know,
a lot of us think we got so much great wisdom
because we go online, we open this so-called white man book, we read this, we read that. We think we know it all. We know it all. No, we don't.
Nah.
According to this Bible, we don't know nothing.
Yeah.
We
Numbers chapter 15, verse 38. Speak!
Because if you had known the Bible, you would have known when the word of God come out, you cannot cover your head. That's the first thing.
My hair messed up.
That's the first thing you would have known that.
Yeah.
When the Bible come out, the scripture say the man got to uncover his head.
Yeah.
It's clear about that. That's the first thing I know you're not one of us. Read.
Speak! Unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
Make fringes in the borders of their garment. Why?
Throughout their generation.
Throughout our generation. Forever. Read.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
A borders of ribbon of blue.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it.
This is why.
And remember all the commandments of the Lord, and do them.
The reason the fringes was for, you remember your sin. When you're about to commit sin, you look at the fringes. That will stop you from coming to sin. That's the purpose of, you gotta have fringes in all your clothes. That's the purpose. You're about to commit adultery, you look at your fringes, you say, you know something, the Bible say, thou shalt commit adultery.
If you look at what, man?
If you look at this,
that's remind you of keeping the law. That's what that means. Yes.
Remember you.
That's what that means. Remember I told you earlier. Every law God give you, give it to us for a reason. God don't just wake up one day and run his mouth like the Negroes do.
No, God put his word. God said, my word should not go out void. Whatever is in the Bible, that's what we must do. Stop complaining. Stop doing the word of God. A lot of us think we got the greatest wisdom. We got this, we know this, because we go online, we go this, we read in this book. No, according to the Bible, we don't know nothing.
You're right.
We must humble ourselves and come here and repent and start doing what the Bible says. Stop thinking we got more knowledge. Some of us think we got more knowledge than God.
Yeah,
God said, those are the children of Israel. But why is this that? Brother, do what the Bible says. How is that going to help you out? That's not going to help you out. By you arguing, oh, I read this right here, the so-called this, the so-called this, that, the Israelite. How the hell are going to help you salvation?
Yeah, you talking about us
personally. The first thing you must do is repent. Start doing what the Bible says.
Yeah.
Don't worry about this. Every man must have their own salvation. Repent, get yourself right. That's not going to help you out. Christ come today, you're going to die. Period. Yeah. Your question should be, what must I do to get in the kingdom of heaven? Stop worrying about who's Israelite or not.
Yes,
stop worrying. That's not your concern. Let God worry about that.
I guess that's not your concern. I guess the one drop rule just keeps hitting me. Like, when people want to call themselves black, but like their dad might be white or something. You know what I mean? Or might be a different nation.
Stop worrying about that, bro. Get yourself right. Give me first King 8. This is what you should do. And I'm only going to show you this because I love you as my brother. This is what I'm going to show you.
1 Kings chapter 8, verse 46. If they sin against thee, if they sin against thee, we all was enemies of sin one time or another. God said if they sin against thee, because we are enemies of sin. We was born in sin.
Now, the Bible is going to show you how to repent. Read.
For there is no man that sinneth not.
Every man sin. Read.
And they'll be angry with them.
Is God angry with us? Absolutely. Look at us. Look at our community. You're not going to fight Puerto Rican. What is your name, black man?
That's right.
What is your name? You must remember who you are. You must return to your nationality. God-given name. What does God call you? You must return to that name.
So who are we?
You are from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
I'm from the tribe of Levi. We are the Israelite. That's what that's talking about. You cannot repent as an African-American. You don't want to know why? You know why, brother? Why? Because God never called you African American.
That's right.
You must repent as Judah. You must repent as Ephraim. Minister.
God is nothing.
That's what God never called you Haitian. God never called you Jamaican. God don't know us by those names. God knows us as Levi, Judah, Benjamin, Ephraim, Simeon, Gad, Reuben, Zebulun, Naphtali. Those are the names God knows us by. You must return to that name. Read.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves in the land whither they were carried captives.
Where they were captive, where do we call it captive? We call it captive in this land, in Haiti, Jamaica. They were brought us in chain. Read.
And repent.
And do what?
And repent.
Do what?
And repent.
Each and every one of us must repent.
That's right.
We must repent or we're going to die here in America. Period. There ain't going to be no excuse. If you don't repent, keep these laws, you will die here. Read. Hold on, bro.
And make supplication.
You hear that? What God said? Make supplication. How do you make supplication? He's going to explain it. Wait, read. No. Go finish reading that.
And make supplication unto thee in the land of them that carried them captives.
Read on.
Say.
That this is... When you make supplication, when you repent, this is what you must say. Read.
We have sinned.
The way you repent, you got to tell God, I have sinned.
And have done perversely.
We've done evil. All of us is evil.
Right.
The black men think they're the most righteous in the planet. And no, you are evil. We're going to kill each other. It's not the so-called woman who's killing us. We're going to sell dope to each other. We don't want to weapon a woman. At night when you go to the bank, you're not watching out for the white man. You're watching for our people to not to rob you, not to kill you.
Right.
Come on, let's tell the truth.
Yeah.
Be truthful.
Yeah.
We the one who's destroying each other.
Right.
Not the so-called white man. So, now you got something. Every time one of the police, a white officer, put one of us to death, everybody want to march. But when the black men kill each other, nobody say nothing. Like it's normal. You know how evil that is?
Right.
You know how wicked that is?
You're right.
Yeah.
You're right.
We have committed wickedness.
We have committed wickedness. We are a wicked people.
Right.
Read.
And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul.
God said you must return to him with all the heart, the mind.
Yeah.
You see our sisters? Look at how our sisters dress. You wanna know how you wanna know why our sisters dress like that? Because we black men, we're not right.
That's right.
We are not right. I'm telling you, that's why you see a woman dressed like that. We're not right.
They don't listen though. I mean,
when guess what? When the black men change, When the black men get themselves together, the black woman is gonna follow.
That's right.
Until then, you still gonna see foolishness like that in the black community.
So that every
you still gonna see our sister dressing like hoes.
So every,
and some of you like the fact that our sister dressed like hoes.
So
guess
every,
what? You're gonna die here in America.
So every woman born in their own flesh. Brother, the Bible says, get you repent, get yourself right.
I feel you.
When you repent,
the black woman is gonna follow. Don't worry about the black woman. Once you repent, when the black woman see you get yourself right, she's gonna get herself right. And today, you wanna know why?
Because you
are the leaders.
She gonna call you a lion and talk about money and all that.
You are the brother. Don't worry about that.
I agree with you.
That's what the Bible said. When you change, she's gonna change.
Yeah.
Right now, you wanna know why she's like that? Because you're the way you are. I'm telling you straight. Let me tell you something. You see all of us here?
They don't like nice respect.
Brother, you see all of us here? Only one or two of us is not married. We all got wives.
Yeah.
We all got wives that follow the law of the Bible.
Yeah.
We taking care of our children. We taking care of our women. We work. That's what the Bible said. The problem with the black men, they don't want to take care of. The black men want to have kids all over the place without taking care of them. That's not of the Bible. That's not a righteous man. That's what you call, excuse my language, but that's what you call a nigger.
Right, yeah.
We are the sons of God. We are no niggers.
Right.
We got to come out of that mind frame. Niggers was created in America.
Yeah.
God don't call us niggers. God call us the sons and daughters of the living God. Until you get yourself right, the black woman will never change. You got to change. You want the black woman to change, but you don't want to change.
Brother,
you got to change first. Don't worry about the black woman.
True.
Whatever's that the baby mama you have, don't worry about her. Change first.
I mean, because that's why I stay single for a long time.
Change
first.
When you change, then she wanna change. You talking about the black woman, but you don't wanna do a damn thing. You don't wanna do nothing. You selling drugs.
They mock you though.
You sleeping with many different women, but you talking about bad about the black woman.
True.
That make no damn sense. That's a hypocrite.
What?
Right.
I agree.
And so return unto thee with all thy heart.
God said you must return to him with all thy heart. The heart is the mind.
Right.
Read.
And with all thy soul.
With all your soul.
In the land of their enemies.
In the land of their enemies. God said you must repent in this land. You must repent, come back to the law, statute and commandment. Start keeping the law. Whatever the Bible said, brother, do it. Stop complaining. Do what the Bible said.
I want to ask you a question.
What did you question? Oh, hold on.
I'm sorry.
I mean, go ahead. It's all good.
All right.
I just have a little testimony.
You have a question or what?
I guess it could be a question.
Well, you... You don't have a testimony.
Okay.
The testimony you should have is what the testimony of the Bible.
That's right.
There is no such a thing as I have a testimony.
Okay.
We are supposed to have the testimony of Christ.
What is the testimony of the Bible?
Do you have a question, yes or no?
I have a testimony of the Bible. That's what you want to hear, right?
Brother, did you hear me?
I want you to go save yourself.
Do you have a question or not?
I have a testimony.
You don't want to hear your testimony. I really don't. I'm sorry.
I got a question.
Okay, the Ten Commandments. I was reading the Ten Commandments. I had it up on the wall. I read the Ten Commandments. In my mind, that's what we're supposed to live by. My son comes in, said the Ten Commandments off the wall. I said, why you doing that? Daddy, we're not living by the law no more. We're living by grace.
Yeah.
And he made me angry. He made me angry when he did that.
Yeah. According to the Ten Commandments, a man shall not sleep with another man. Is that in the Ten Commandments?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
It's not in there, is it?
It's not, brother.
Ten Commandments.
A woman shall not lay down with another woman. Is that a thing coming in the Ten Commandments?
Rape.
Is that in the Ten Commandments? Does that mean we can do it?
No, I said, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not bear false witness. Thou shalt not come with thy neighbor.
A man not supposed to sleep with an animal. Is that in the Ten Commandments?
I don't think so.
No, it's not.
But what did I tell you? There is more than Ten Commandments, brother.
That's what I heard. Yeah, that's right. There are more.
There is more.
Okay.
So what I'm, all these sins I just mentioned to you, those are things we're not supposed to do. They're not in the Ten Commandments. But those are laws.
Okay.
There is way more laws. Christianity is always about the Ten Commandments.
Right.
We got 633 laws.
Right. So what are we going to live by? The law or the Ten Commandments?
It's the same thing.
Thank you. That's what I thought.
What were we calling?
Great.
No, hold on. Finish that.
But sir, can we live by these young commandments?
Brother, you must sleep by God every,
word of God. But he said, if you fail one, you fail them all.
Brother, listen. You must sleep by every word of God.
God said you got to have a beard, have a beard. God said you need fringes, put fringes. God said to keep the Sabbath, keep it. God said keep the high holidays, keep it. God said you must. Whatever the Bible said, that's what you must do.
Okay.
Right. Don't worry about everything else.
But I'm just saying, can we do that?
Yes, you can. We're doing that right now.
That's right.
But if we're doing it, yes, you can. It's easy to do. But you don't want to make it difficult.
That's right. I just have a question.
It's very easy for you to let your beard grow. You know how easy it is for you to let your beard grow? You know how easy it is for you to go to the store, buy this, and put it on your shirt? You know how easy it is? That don't even cost $10 to do. You know how easy it is? You know how easy it is to wake up today to say, I'm going to keep the Sabbath?
So, should we get baptized first and then start first and then get baptized?
Because the Bible is
specific about that. Dandruff and crust up all of it.
Yeah,
I just moved out here 2 weeks ago.
Romans chapter 8, verse 48. And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul.
Remember what we were talking about, how to repent. You know?
In the land of their enemies, which led them away captive. And pray unto thee.
And pray unto Mosai.
Toward their land.
Towards the land which is Jerusalem. Jerusalem is our land. We must pray towards Jerusalem, which is our land. Not Africa. Jerusalem is our land, which is the east. You know?
Which thou gavest unto the fathers, the city which thou hast chosen, and the house which I have built for thy name.
Now, bro, did you just buy this soda today?
That's another Lord you with me.
The soda?
Yeah.
What's up with the soda?
Yes. Today is the Sabbath. Thou shalt not buy it. Thou shalt not sell it.
Okay.
Thou shalt not open it. Yeah. That's the Lord you with.
All right. Everything God said. That we're not doing it. Everything God said that we are not doing.
Brothers,
we cannot keep God's law. Only Jesus can keep it.
He missed the whole point, didn't he?
He missed it for hours.
I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets up. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.